Talofa lava. My name is Maina Vai. I'm a journalist from Samoa. I'm now standing at the village of Whalatai, in the district of Whalatai and Samatau on the island of Upolu. We've got two islands, two large islands. One is the big island of Savai and second to large is Upolu, where we are right now. Today is our project of breath of the weather and setting up of our Aeolian wind harp. So we came all the way from Fastauta, a village close to the Faleolo airport on the north of this island, so that we can set up here at Whalatai. But we were supposed to set up on the mountain. There is a mountain not far from us, and it's on the other side of the village, and it's called Mafafa. So we were planning of setting up our Aeolian wind harp on the island with our tripods and everything. But the thing is that according to the weatherman and the Met Office here in Apia, they say that we will be experiencing winds coming from the east of Upolu. So to what we've seen that if we set up on the mountain, the winds will hit the back of the mountain and we'll probably not get the good sound and the proper sound that we need. But here we are, it's just behind our house here, where we set up Aeolian wind harp. As you can see, we use the car battery for our weights. So we put the car battery inside the shopping bag and then hang it so to firm the strings. So hopefully we get the good sound and everything that feel wanted. So that's our setup today. And I must say something about this project, the breath of weather. In Samoa, breath of weather is manawa litau or manawanga litau. Breath means manawanga or manawa, and weather means tau. So gathering the sounds inside the wind harp is what we call, I think we call in my own thoughts, we called in Samoan siufufonga olesavili, or the sound of the wind. So this project is a very good one and I really like it because I'm someone who like to experience research for the environment, the weather and everything. According to this time in the world, we've been experiencing a lot of changes because of climate change. I hope you like our setup and we hope we can get what feel wanted and the crew, the perfect sounds that you want and a great win for this evening. Yeah, that's it from us. In Samoan, we say, "Tō whasei fua, manuia tele le aso." And in English, we say, "Goodbye and have a blessed day."
road used to be down here. They used to walk a long way to the beach. I'm told. All those little bushes used to extend further out. This ridge has been cut away, so much so that I lost my other table. Here's my new one. It went away with a large sea a couple of weeks ago. These trees are dying. There was one more. This used to be green, and a bush. The kids would play in it, you could hide in them, at little caves. Now it's hanging on.
Taranaki, Taimauna, all of this region sits on the sides of a mountain. A mountain flowing down to the sea, yes. Cutting through all the way down to the shore. Here we stand on Puripo. Grateful to the community for permitting us to place the harp here. Thank you.
This is the third morning in a row of this heavy kind of foggy start to the day. But I mean, this is midwinter and we're getting the most incredibly glorious sunny days. It's like it's spring. Spring has kind of thrust forward. I don't know, 2 months. It's a bit weird. On the edge of Rangitoto and Motutapu Islands, the Hauraki Gulf, and the harp here has been singing beautifully. Actually, it's the weather now is just changing back to a really strong northwesterly, and wind and rain starting to come in. And Rangitoto is the most recent volcanic eruption up here about 650 years ago, and yeah, it's a magic place, but boy, when the weather hits here, it's like any island, it's very exposed, so it's pretty wild here at the moment. Okay, well, the weather this past week has been incredibly variable. Unseasonably warm weather for this time of the year. I mean, we're talking about this is mid-July here in Auckland, and the weather is so unseasonable. It's temperatures are ranging still, you know, between about 12 to 18 in Auckland, depending on days and what's happening. But I mean, just recently the weather has been incredibly variable. I mean, very wet, and I mean, a lot of flooding in the south, but Auckland's not so bad. But also the tides have been remarkably high, particularly with this last full moon phase. I know that impacted hugely in Pacific Islands also, but even around here there's quite a big impact on the coast. So, you know, these changes are, they're right in your face from day to day.
Good Matariki morning.
This is on the beachfront at Uruamu Estuary. It's Matariki Day, in fact, a national celebration day for Matariki. And the weather is really kind of overcast and grey. It's bleak. There's quite a strong wind blowing in from the east, from the northeast. It looks like rain, but whether it will, hey, we will wait and see. But the harp is singing.